but it's Friday. Actually, this is my second attempt at the video, at the vlog. I made a first one, but then the phone kept ringing and all kind of interruptions, and I kept getting texts, and oh my god. So this one is going to be without interruption, hopefully. I'm having a little drink, and now I'm going to have a cigarette. I got home from work, what time is it? Oh, about an hour ago. So let's get started. Okay, so first off, I want to say thank you to the very lovely and beautiful Jen who sent me something in the mail. I love these little card things she sent me. And she sent me, I'll tell you now, she sent me some lip gloss, and I believe this is the lip gloss, if I'm not mistaken, that she made herself. She's been very crafty lately. Here, let's check in here. I love the way it smells, by the way. It's kind of like, god, it smells really good. It's like floral with like a hint of like orange or something. It's orange, isn't it? You put like some kind of citrus in here. Please get back to me and tell me. But anyways, I actually used this today. Thank you for sending me this. It cheered me up. I love whatever you send me. And yay for being so creative. You're so sweet. And I love you too. So, don't worry guys. I work now. So, care packages very soon to all my loved ones. I can't wait to spoil you all again. For those that I don't have your address, email me your address. I'm on Twitter. You can DM me your address. And my Twitter link is on my blog. And if you don't follow my blog, then please follow the blog so you can get all my links. And then you can get free goodies in the mail. And as for the very beautiful Jess, I haven't sent you an email in a little bit, sweetie, because I've been working. But don't worry, I'm going to send you an email. And I love you and I hope you're doing well. And I miss our little email chats. And give your daughter a big hug and a kiss from me. And why are you not posting? Well, I can't blame you. I haven't been on Instagram posting pictures either, but whatever. I'll email you soon, okay? I promise. So I love you too. Okay. And also one more to Perry. Thank you for all the messages and the packages. He sent some things for my kid, and I think I forgot to thank him better late than never. But thank you, sweetie. You're so sweet. You never cease to surprise me. So I'm sorry that for anyone who I haven't mentioned, I'm sorry if I haven't been on much, but I have a job now, so I've been working. But I have to find a balance. Don't worry, I'm gonna incorporate all of you back in again. So bear with me. Now, let's talk about work. Okay, today makes like a week, I think, that I've officially started working. So, the whole working process, if you will. And I like to tell you that work is good. I like my job. I like what I do. I like who I am when I work. And work is good. Work is really, really good. The very first couple days were trying because my body had to get used to being up for so many hours doing something. So the worst of it was my feet and my thighs, of all things. My thighs really, really hurt because I'm constantly bending up and down in the pharmacy. Believe it or not, you go up and down a lot in the pharmacy. You have like these huge walls with medication, and you have to go up and put them away and get down and put them, go back up and go down. And the same thing with medicine, when you have to look for someone's medication. Up and down, up and down. I do a lot of squats at work. Oh my god. I'm going to say that that's the bonus about doing squats. Because my butt, I think my butt is getting bigger. I don't know if that's attributed to the squats and whatnot, but let's say it's perkier. I don't want to say bigger, I want to say perkier. So thank you, squats, and thank you, company, for providing me with exercise at work. Okay, work is good. I love work. My friend, the very lovely, beautiful friend that I have, my oldest, dearest friend, my kid's godmother, she is my trainer. I'm gonna train with her next week, and she's also my number one fan. I love her for that. She believes I can do it, and she's put a lot of faith in me. I don't want to let her down. So she decided to take a little survey around the store about me and my performance, how I'm doing, how I'm getting along with the coworkers, how I'm doing in overall job performance. And apparently she got positive feedback, nothing but good reviews. Everyone loves me at the store. They think I'm doing a great job. They love that I'm a quick learner. I'm doing good so far, A plus. So I'm happy about that. There is actually someone at the store that, it's not that I don't like him. I mean, I don't dislike people. Honestly, I'm one of those weird people that I don't hate people. You know, like for instance, you can hate on me and all that, but if I don't really know you well enough, I can't really have things to hate you for. You understand? So, like, I can't say, "Oh my gosh, he's such a bitch." You know, I can't be like that. "Oh God, he's such an asshole." Like, I could say he's an asshole, but I don't have no merit to really consider him an asshole. You know, like I cannot not stand the person. You know. So he just happens to be one of those people that he's an older gentleman. We're gonna call him. Oh God, he's kind of bitter and mean all the time. So I don't know. What can we call him? What can we call someone who appears to be bitter and mean and uptight all the time? Jeez, I don't know. Let's call him tight ass because it's like he has a stick up there and he's just clenching it for dear life. So, Mr. Tight Ass. Apparently, from what it looks like on the outside, he doesn't like me. He said already, it's been twice already, I've had two incidents with him. I'm not trained 100%. There are some things that I just don't know. But like I said, I'm one of those people that I'm hands-on. So I pick up things very quickly. I've been doing a fantastic job so far picking up everything. There are some things that, yes, I don't know, but it's because no one has taught me. Because the majority of things that I know are things that are relevant to what we have to do on a daily basis. Like, there are some technical things that I don't know, but that's because I haven't been taught. But that's what training is for. So, next week, I suspect, are more technicality. So, apparently, this man, tight ass, is, he. Tight ass. If you have a better nickname for someone like that, please tell me. Okay, so tight ass made a comment about me, and then today he made another comment. He mentioned something about, "Oh, well, you just have these people and they don't know how to do this. All they know how to do is that." And so apparently it's like I make his job harder, but I'm not trying to. It's just that like I said, I'm not trained for that. But it's not to say that I won't ever be like that. I'm sure that, listen, I love my job, I love work, I take work very seriously. You're not gonna see me fucking around at work. I mean, there's time to play and whatnot and fuck around and laugh and all that shit. That's, you know, obviously, you're not gonna be like, "Ooh, like a fucking robot working on, like, and you're in a damn factory and shit." But right now, I have to be on, you know, I have to learn everything, so I have to be on point, you know? It's not to say that I don't have fun and whatnot at work. Today I got invited to one of the workers there. She's very sweet and bubbly. We're gonna call her Bubbles because she's so bubbly. So Bubbles invites me to go out tomorrow to a restaurant, to Chili's, to go eat and have drinks and talk shit and wine and whatnot. I have to work tomorrow. I'm actually getting out an hour earlier from the time that they're gonna go, but I have my kid with me tomorrow. I don't have a car. You know, there's things stacked against me, so I can't go. It's nice that they invited me. I have a manager there who's very sweet. He's so sweet that he has a little metal bucket just full of chocolates that he fills every day for all of us, you know? He's so sweet. He walks around sometimes on break and just hands out chocolates to everyone to kind of get people going, and sugar and chocolate makes you happy. And so That was so sweet. He handed me a little teeny tiny Mr. Good Bar miniature chocolate thing, and I ate it. So, but he's a sweetheart. He's the reason why I need a better phone. I have a cheap minute phone, and I need a government phone. I have a government minute phone. I have a cheap. I like to call it government cheese phone. I need a smartphone now. I need a good smartphone. It's been a while since I've had a good phone, so I don't know what is a good phone now. I mean, there's so many, you know. So, if you have any suggestions, please tell me what is a good smartphone to have that's affordable. And so, he likes to send text a lot. He texts the schedule. He likes to text messages. He's always texting. My goodness. That's not a problem, except that my phone, I don't have like a little QWERTY keyboard. I don't have shit, you understand? It's hard for me to send a text. For me to send a nice text, I have to be there like 3 minutes, just, you understand? So, but he loves to send texts. He sends schedules and all kind of things. So I need a good phone so I can keep up with him. Because apparently he likes to send me text. Like he'll send me a text, like a good text, and then later he'll send me like 3 or 4 or 5 texts with like one syllable words or nothing but like happy faces or winky faces, you know, like so. Oh my god, I can't keep up with that right now. So I need a good phone so I can keep up with him. But he's a total sweetheart, you know. He's been training me. I just can't get over saying how sweet he is, because he is. He's a very sweet, genuine man. He's so sweet that he actually told me that if I go tomorrow to the thing, to let him know that he'll actually come and pick me up and take me, and I can go with him. And I thought that was sweet. You know, he lives, I don't know where, but he has no business coming down here and taking me, you understand? But he's a sweetheart. I'm so grateful for someone like that. But back to Mr. Tightass. Mr. Tightass, I found out today from my friend that apparently Mr. Tightass likes me. See, I'm thinking all this time he doesn't like me. He likes me. He likes me so much that he actually was the one who had the final say in my hiring. Yes. He wanted me in the pharmacy. He kept asking me, where's so-and-so? Where is she? Why is she not here? You need to hurry up and hire this girl. So, I know that Mr. Tightass and myself are having like a little bit of a miscommunication because, you know, he's an older man, you know, fucking geriatrics, how they are, they're just set in their ways and shit. So, but I know I can win this guy over. I know, apparently my friend tells me that I have to speak more Spanish with him, that'll win him over, although his English is impeccable. He doesn't even have one of those cute accents that I like. But, apparently I have to win him over. She just tells me to act more Cuban with him. I don't know what acting more Cuban is, but I suspect. I have to dig deep back into my childhood. So I think, but I can win him over. I know. I can win anyone over, I think. I don't think I'm that bad of a person that you can't fall madly in love with me. So I'm just kidding. But anyways, yeah, I know I can get him. It's just going to take a little bit. We have to get to know each other. I know once we get to know each other, because I don't have malice in my heart. I don't really hate anyone. So I know that we're going to get over this little funk. So, other than that, work is spectacular. I only had one incident today with somebody. It was a guy who was doing insurance fraud. He had 4 medications. He didn't know which one was what. And apparently some were what we call them, controlled substances, which are like Oxycontin, you know, all these like strong prescription medications that people abuse. And he also had like a strong weight loss medication. So apparently, you know, he didn't know what was what, and the pharmacist, stick in the ass, gave him Tightass, gave him a hassle about it, and the guy was completely just pissed off. He blew up on everyone in the pharmacy, myself included. I had charged him for his medication, and apparently he wanted to debit debit the purchase, and he ended up hitting credit. And so what happens when you hit credit, the purchase went through. When you hit credit, you get a receipt and you have to sign on the dotted line. So I give him the pen, I'm like, listen, you have to sign. I don't have to fucking sign anything because I debited this shit. So he balls up the receipt and he throws it. He doesn't throw it at my face, but he throws it in my direction. So, oh my god, what a prick. But I didn't take it as such because I have the last laugh. Because you're fucking thinking that you debited the shit when you credited. So when you get your bank statement, you're gonna have a big surprise, buddy. So ha ha ha. But anyways, whatever. Some people are just naturally miserable. Work is great. What else can I tell you? I've lost 6 pounds since I started working. I am having trouble eating. I believe anorexia is back and strong. And I eat a little bit. I was surprised today. I ate a lot. And I came home and I weighed myself, which I shouldn't do. But I've been weighing myself less. Okay, don't give me hassles. And apparently I've lost. So, yeah, 6 pounds as of today. Eating is hard. I don't know what to eat. I try to eat anything. I eat pathetic things like, oh my god, like fucking protein bars and protein shakes, or meal replacement shakes, or fucking a piece of bread with mayonnaise on it, or a scoop of peanut butter, or what else do they eat? Oh my god, I don't know. I tried to eat like fruit today. Not fruit, but like applesauce, and I think I tried to eat like a baby food or something that had fruit in it, and it was disgusting. I had to throw it away. I just did not want it. So eating is getting a little bit hard for me right now. I find food irrelevant right now. I don't want to eat, you know? I can't. Making myself eat is a challenge now. I don't know what it is. I just do not want to eat, so it's hard. Like I was telling you last week, the eating disorder is, it can't go one way, so it's trying to go another way to get me, and apparently that's what it's doing. I don't know what's gonna happen. Oh my god, the camera just died. I have 2 batteries in it today. Remind me that I have to get batteries tomorrow, and a lock, because I have a locker now. I can't bring my purse inside the pharmacy because, for obvious reasons, they think that I'm going to steal all the medicines and shit and become like this big-time drug dealer. But I have a locker now, so I have to store my purse there, but I don't have a lock, so I have to buy a lock tomorrow, and I have to buy batteries. But anyways, so let me try to hurry up and wrap this up. So yeah, work is good. It's great. I'm doing okay. Eating disorder's bad. I'm losing weight. I'm not eating. I haven't seen my boyfriend, and it's gonna be like a month now. My work schedule is hectic. We have kids. We have school. We haven't been able to just cross paths, so it's really depressing. Because I am in love with this man, and it's hard. I don't know how to have a relationship anymore. That's why I never wanted to have a long distance relationship with anyone, because it hurts. It hurts me. I don't like to be away from anyone that I love. I can't stand it. So although we're in the same city, in the same state, it just feels like a long distance relationship right now, because, you know, we just don't have time to see each other. So it's very depressing. It hurts me. It makes me sad, and I hate it, but there's nothing really that we can do about it except just, you know, wait and see when we can find time to see each other. What else can I tell you? God, my ex sold my car. He was supposed to sell it for $1,200. He took it to some guy to look at it. The guy drove the car. All of a sudden, my car decided to die completely. The engine locked up, and my car died in the middle of the street some damn where. And so the guy decided he didn't want to buy the car anymore. So he offered $500 to basically junk the car, and that was about it. So my ex junked my car for $500, and he only gave me $300. Can you believe that shit? Instead of giving me the whole $500, he only gave me $3. So, yep. I don't know. But there's a God up there, I'm hoping. You know, you get what you put out. You can't really be acting like a slick asshole and don't think it's gonna come back to you. So, whatever. I don't know what else to tell you guys. I think that's it. I'm gonna try to merge these two videos together some damn how. I hope you're all doing well. I'm gonna vlog again tomorrow. Tomorrow's another long day. I got my first paycheck today, and they stiffed me. I was supposed to get over 20, so almost 30 hours, and they only paid me for 19 hours. So I'm very unhappy right now. My pay is not what I expected. So tomorrow I have to fucking go and get one of these managers and claim all of this, and hopefully it could get fixed, or whatever. such is working life. So that's it. I'll talk to you all again tomorrow. That's it. Good night.